Okay, welcome to turn six. We're going to be rolling for the spy. One country gets to roll that didn't get to roll last time, and one country doesn't get to roll that did get to roll last time. Germany and Finland get to roll, but the minor axis do not because their capital is currently in Russian hands. So let's do Germany, 4. Finland, 3. Russia, 2. United States, 1. Japan, 5. Italy, 3. UK, whose capital just got liberated, 1. South Africa, 3. Canada, 2. And the Aussies, 4. So, no sixes in this roll. The highest roll is Japan. So Japan has the spy this turn. Okay, the German minor axis and Finnish turn. The Finns have 8 IPCs to spend. They're going to buy 2 mechanized infantry. The Germans have 39 IPCs to spend. They're going to buy a carrier with a fighter on it and a cruiser. And they're going to save an IPC for next turn. They do have some attacks to wage. They are going to try and liberate the minor axis capital of Romania. So they will do that with 3 tanks and 3 mechanized infantry from Germany. There will also be a paradrop from 2 German infantry from Germany. The other strategic bomber is going to finally knock out that transport in C-Zone 100, so that's what that's going to do. The Belarus will be attacked with 2 artillery, 1 tank, and 1 mech infantry from Novosibirsk, and Archangel will be attacked with the Finnish tank and mech infantry from Novosibirsk, and 2 tanks and 2 mech infantry from Karelia. So those are the attacks. Let's get rolling. Here's the attack on Romania. 3 tanks, 3 mech infantry, and 2 paradropped units. So 3 threes, 3 twos, 2 ones. 2 hits. So that's 1 artillery and 1 tank have been killed. 3 tanks and an artillery. 2 hits. So that's the 2 infantry killed. Three hits. So that's, there's only 2 left. So battle's won, but the Germans inflict 2 more casualties. So Germany liberates the territory with 2 infantry and 2 mech infantry casualties. Okay, in a battle for C-Zone 100, the German strategic bomber is going up against the SS Zirianen. This is an auto-kill, so there's no dice, but the transport is finally killed. Okay, a battle for Belarus. Tank, mech infantry, 2 artillery. 1 hit, that's all they needed. Russian response. They do get a hit, so they're going to kill one of the artilleries. Germany takes the territory. Okay, battle for Archangel. 2 German tanks and a Finnish tank, 2 German mech infantry and a Finnish mech infantry. So 3 threes, 3 twos, 3 hits. Only needed 1. Rush and response. Finns are going to lose in mech infantry. So the Germans will take this territory, and the Finns lose a single mech infantry as a casualty. Okay, non-combat. One of the two infantry from Normandy-Bordeaux is going to move to Holland-Belgium. The two infantry in the AA gun in Holland-Belgium are going to move into Western Germany. One AA gun, a tank, and a mechanized infantry are going to move into Germany. Actually, you know what? I'm going to go this way. The guy in Poland, the infantry or the artillery unit in Poland is going to move into Germany. And the infantry that's in Baltic states is going to move into Eastern Poland as a blocker. The bomber that acted as an airborne transport in Romania is going to go to Western Germany. And the bomber from C-Zone 100 is going to go to Germany. And then the Navy in C-Zone 127 will load up a Finnish infantry from Karelia, a Finnish tank from Finland, and then on the way by a Finnish infantry from Norway. And they will disembark in C-Zone 112 and go into Western Germany. So that is that, I think. Yeah, we're done there. So let me tidy this up and we'll be right back. Okay, German placements, the new carrier and fighter, plus the new cruiser. We're going to go into this slot here. And the Finns, of course, are going to place their units in Finland. Okay, changes to income. The minor axis get their capital back, so they're going to be +3. And then Germany is going to get +2 from the Russians. So +2 for Germany, +3 for the minor axis, and -5 for the Russians. So the Russians are at 38. They're going to go down to 33. Germany's going to go to 35. And the minor axis are going to go to 8. Okay, so minor axis have 8. Finns have 7. The Germans have 35 and they saved an IPC, so they're going to have 36 for next turn. Okay, disposition of forces. C-Zone 112. One carrier with a fighter on it, one destroyer, 2 cruisers and a sub, and 3 transports. Holland, Belgium, 1 infantry. Normandy, Bordeaux, 1 infantry, 1 anti-aircraft. Southern France, 2 infantry. Western Germany, 2 infantry, 2 anti-aircraft, and a strategic bomber. Also, there's 2 Finnish infantry and a Finnish tank. Germany has a strategic bomber, artillery and anti-aircraft, a tank, and a mechanized infantry. Finland has 2 mechanized infantry. Novgorod has... you know what? I'm just going to make a change on the fly here. This AA gun is going to go into Belarus. It was here, it's going to go there. Archangel, 2 tanks, 2 mechanized infantry, and a Finnish tank. Belarus, tank, mech, artillery, and now a anti-aircraft. Eastern Poland, infantry. Romania, 3 tanks, and a mechanized infantry. And I think that's all the German and Finnish units. They're minor axis don't actually have any pieces on the board, and they actually won't have any pieces on the board until turn 7, because they're going to have to get enough money to buy some sort of a factory or a military base or something like that. But their capital is, for now, liberated, although the Russians could certainly take it back. So we'll see what happens on Russia's turn 6, so that's coming up.